Hello friends, welcome to a brand new episode of Kel Stories. As we promised, we bring to you yet another new episode on a Friday evening. For the past 3 weeks, we have been bringing you some passionate and emotional stories from the world of sports. So it's time to lighten the mood a bit and highlight the interesting and funny side of the sporting world. So this week our focus is on the ongoing Olympics, the grandest and the most celebrated sporting event in the whole world. Today, we bring to you some of the weird and unbelievable facts about Olympics that you might have never heard before. Just for clarification, by Olympics, we will refer to the modern Summer Olympics. So, without any further ado, let's get started. What if I tell you that the most coveted Olympic gold medal is actually not made of gold? Hard to believe, isn't it? The Olympic gold medal is made mostly of silver and it is gold-plated with about 6 grams of gold. While silver medals are made out of pure silver and bronze medals are mainly made out of copper. An Olympic gold medal weighs about 556 grams. That means a little more than 1% of a gold medal is made of actual gold and the rest 99% contains silver. Talking about its value, the approximate price of a gold medal in Tokyo Olympics is 65,000 in Indian currency. How was your life when you were a 10-year-old? Probably you were busy doing your school homework or playing gully cricket or football with your friends, or maybe you are into video games, right? Now imagine someone winning an Olympic medal at the age of 10. Incredible, isn't it? Dimitrios Londras, Greek gymnast, became the youngest Olympian to win a medal at the age of 10 years and 218 days by helping his team win a bronze medal in parallel bars at the 1896 Athens Olympics. Now coming from the youngest to the oldest, Swedish shooter Oskar Svan won silver in the 1920 Olympics at the age of 72. Can you imagine? Before you start thinking it's too late to achieve something in life, take a moment and think about the incredible achievement of Oskar Svan. And just in case you didn't know already, there is no age limit for participating in the Olympics. This depends on each international sports federation and the rules it lays down for its sport. For a cricket-obsessed nation, one of the biggest regrets of Indians is the non-inclusion of cricket in Olympics. There are 33 sports featuring in Tokyo 2020 Olympics, but sadly India's most followed sport, cricket, is not one of them. But before you think that there has never been any affiliation of cricket with Olympics, let me tell you that cricket was played in the 1900 Paris Olympics. Great Britain won the gold while host France won the silver medal. Initially, 4 teams were supposed to compete in cricket, but Belgium and Netherlands pulled out at the last moment. The only match played at the 1900 Olympics was a 2-day match which the Great Britain won by 158 runs. India may not have participated in the 1900 Cricket Olympics, but a bit of good news for Indian cricket fans, there's a high probability that T20 cricket is going to be featured in the 2028 Los Angeles Olympics, and BCCI has agreed to send both the men's and the women's cricket team. Though many sports find it hard to be included in the Olympics, there has been some hilarious and outright bizarre sports competitions in the early Olympics. Let's talk about a few of them. What if I told you the tug of war you played in your school days was actually a sport in the Olympics? Imagine 8 men pulling a 6-foot row for 5 minutes. That's exactly what happened in 6 Olympics from 1900 to 1920. No points for guessing who dominated tug of war. Great Britain, of course. In case you think this fact is weird, let me bring your attention towards rope climbing. Maybe the Olympic committee were clueless and ran out of ideas, just like any Salman Khan movie, or maybe the committee was headed by some 10-year-old kid. Jokes aside, rope climbing was first introduced in the 1896 Athens Olympics and it continued till 1932 Olympics. Each contestant had to climb a 14-meter tall rope, and during the first few Olympics they were judged both on time and style. Now before I move from the hilarious to the bizarre part, a bit of warning to the animal lovers. You may want to skip the next few seconds and head directly to the next fact. Pigeon hunting was actually a sport in the 1900 Paris Olympics. The competitors had to shoot live pigeons, and anyone who failed to shoot 2 consecutive pigeons was eliminated. On the day of the competitions, the ground turned into a slaughterhouse with around 300 pigeons killed. After protests from numerous animal rights activists, live pigeons were replaced with clay pigeons from the next Olympics. When in doubt, trust coffee. This seems to be the principle of coffee lovers all across the world. Brazil Olympic Committee took these words very seriously when they sent 84 Brazilian delegates to 1932 Olympics in a ship with 50,000 pounds of coffee. With the Great Depression setting in, most of the countries sent only a limited number of participants for the 1932 Olympics. But the Brazilian authorities sent all the candidates hoping that they would win medals and will also sell coffee on their way to recover this cost. Unfortunately, the Brazilian sportspersons managed to collect only $24 by selling coffee beans. In 1932, USA charged $1 to enter the country. So, the coaches selected the best 24 candidates. A few more had the chance of going in, but the rest of the candidates had to spend their time in the ship. However, Brazil could not manage to win a single medal, but still, it was indeed an incredible story. Words cannot express how much the Olympics meant to the Brazilian athletes. See what I did there. Here's a puzzle for you guys. Person X sets a world record in long jump and yet is awarded with an Olympic bronze medal, but not gold. Come on, think for a bit. It's actually not that difficult. American Robert Lee Jondra broke the world record in long jump at the 1924 Games but won the bronze medal because he made the jump in the pentathlon competition. The jump was more than a foot compared to the gold medal long jump winner in 1924 Olympics. But since he wasn't entered in the competition, there was no question of gold. Kids drink beer and call their ex. Adults drink beer and start dancing to Bhojpuri song. Legends drink beer and take part in Olympics. Had to share this one with Khes to his family. Anti-doping rules and regulations were first introduced in the 1968 Mexico Olympics. Urine was collected from the contestants and analyzed for any restricted substances. The first drug disqualification took place when Sweden's Hans Gunnar Liljenvall was banned from modern pentathlon for drinking too much beer. It's said that he drank beer in order to calm his nerves before the competition. The Swedish pentathlon team was eventually stripped of their bronze medal. So friends, that's all for today. Please like and subscribe Khel Stories if you enjoyed watching this video. Do not forget to hit the bell icon for notifications every Friday evening. Let's meet again next week. Stay safe, stay healthy, and keep loving sports. Bye-bye.